How did his father die?
A surgeon never kills a patient. An anesthesiologist can kill a patient, but a surgeon never can.
Hi, everyone. Vegas Film Critic here. Jeff Frick Howard here to review Killing a Sacred Deer. I know what you're thinking. Director Yorgos Lanthimos is making movies again. If The Lobster wasn't enough, this guy's making another movie. And I should say right away, I hated The Lobster. Even though I knew what Yorgos was trying to do, it still didn't connect with me. It still messed with my mind. It made me so angry. For weeks, I was thinking about that movie. Now, I have not watched it again. It deserves a second chance, and I knowing what to expect this time. But I'm telling you, I went into Killing a Sacred Deer. I go to most movies without knowing what they're about. I like to be surprised, unless it's something like a Justice League or something. So I had no idea what this movie's about. I get the end fight to go. I sit in the movie, and 30 minutes into it, starring Colin Farrell. Okay, let me say who stars in it first. Colin Farrell. Jeez, Jeff, come on. Colin Farrell, Nicole Kidman, Rayleigh Cassidy, Suri Soljic, am I saying his name? And Barry Keoghan. And Kogan, he's Irish. So I'm 30 minutes into this movie, and there's Colin Farrell, and the dialogue is being delivered in this really kind of weird monotone way. You know, kind of like, this is not in the movie, but the way I describe it, like, you have nice hair. Oh, thank you. Would you like to use my hairbrush sometime? Certainly. Is it a nice hairbrush? Yeah, it's a very nice hairbrush. Oh, then I would love to use it sometime. So that's the kind of delivery and that kind of bizarre dialogue is going on. I thought 30 minutes into it, I went, this is the guy who directed The Lobster, because it didn't have any opening credits. So I thought, okay, put my seatbelt on, and I was ready for a ride. Now, Colin Farrell plays a surgeon who's gotten involved with his teenage kid, who's almost like they have this weird, strange relationship. He's like, he doesn't have a father, and he's kind of like adopted Colin Farrell. They kind of see each other at the hospital. They have lunch at a diner. So he just kind of worms his way into his family life. And he has a teenage daughter and also a 10-year-old boy, 12-year-old boy. And Nicole Kidman plays the mother, the wife. So Barry Keoghan just kind of just weasels his way into the family. And what's really bizarre about this movie is that it unfolds of a story of revenge. It's really dark, and it's more kind of easier to understand, I think, than the love story in The Lobster. And in this movie, I don't want to, there's spoilers in here, but it's like a modern folktale setting. So it's a folktale, you know, if you hear one of these classic kind of Grimm's fairy tales or a folktale, but they put it in a modern setting. So I think, and I was really intrigued with this. So as the movie went along, I thought to myself, wow, I understand what he's doing, even though his delivery is just such an original kind of unconventional way. And I can see how it was getting me angry, but it was getting me angry in a really artistic, creative way, because I knew what he was doing this time. I was prepared. I knew this guy. And not only that, it just got dark. I mean, it got seriously dark. And it just, I don't want to give away, because I read a lot of like kind of synopsis and stuff, and it doesn't say what the main plot is, and I don't want to tell you what's going on, but it's a really deadly story of revenge, and what a family has to do, has to make choices that are life and death. We'll just put it that way. So Killing a Sacred Deer is just really, I really had a good time with it, but if I recommend it to the average person, I think they're going to get angry because it's super unconventional. So if you want to take a chance on a movie, if you saw The Lobster, you know what you're in for, but I had an easier time watching this than I did The Lobster. But you know what? I was intrigued by this movie, and the more I think about it, I really want to watch it again. The kids' performances are outstanding, and Barry Keoghan's just, he was in Dunkirk, he's just phenomenal in this. And so is Colin Farrell. Nicole Kidman, like you've never seen her before. You know, so this, you know, Yorgos Lanthimos really knows how to attract some A talent to his really strange, unconventional movie making. And Killing a Sacred Deer is probably one of the most bizarre, strange films you'll see this year. And go see it. Please do. All right, for more reviews and interviews, surf on over to my website, VegasFilmCritic.com. Check me out on social media, Facebook and Twitter. Also, if you're watching on YouTube, make sure you hit that subscribe button, that V somewhere down there. Also, thumbs up, share, and comment below. You got to tell me what you thought of this movie. Just don't send me hate mail, because I totally understand if you do. But open your mind, okay? Open your mind to this guy. I'm starting to warm up to him. I got to see his first film, Dogtooth. I haven't seen it. So anyway, thanks for joining me. I'm Jeffrey Gay Howard. I'll see you next time.